What's up, Wappers? Or, as the French say, quoi de neuf? I'm in Paris here, and I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to talk to you all about some of my AP test-taking strategies as we are nearing the finish line here in our end of the year. I'm out here on the balcony, so if the noise level is a bit distracting, I apologize in advance, but I couldn't resist the opportunity to broadcast here from Paris over spring break. Now, sadly, I want to start with being here on the balcony yesterday, getting home in the afternoon and coming out on the balcony and just over my right shoulder. It's hard to see here from the camera angle. However, coming home had a clear view of Notre Dame de Paris, which is the famous Gothic cathedral that was built here in the 12 and 1300s, was on fire. And I'm sure you saw the news. This was an international story that broke out yesterday. So having a live view of that, and I'll show you the images here. I'll put them into the video when I get back to DC and edit this. But my goodness gracious, it was traumatic in a sense to see history being engulfed by Mother Nature. Thankfully, the French fire department was able to put that out to some degree and save the majority of the church. But it's one of the oldest churches left in Europe, and that was just a stunning sight to see yesterday afternoon, early evening. But regardless, let's move forward as we always do in history. And I really wanted to hone in on what I consider to be my three top tips for you all as we're approaching now AP season. But really, the bulk of this video is going to be comprised of former Basis Chandler students that I taught, whether it be in WAP, whether it be in APUSH, sharing their insight. And they're going to give you some tips that they've acquired. And I'll be breaking them up and sort of categorizing how they put things. But regardless, from my three tips, I want to begin. The first is to really set up a schedule. This is something that would go a long way to building up key organizational skills. So I would recommend putting yourself onto some type of regimen where, and again, I mentioned this in class, you really never want to study for more than an hour in one sitting. The brain, you have to treat it like a muscle group. And if you go into the gym and work legs for 4 hours in one day, your legs are going to be mushed the next. You don't want your brain to function like that. And you have to keep in mind, you guys have more than just AP World History to worry about as the end of the year arrives. So I would set us up a schedule where you carve out maybe 3 to 4 days a week where you're studying for WAP for 1 hour at a time. And during that 1 hour, you can focus on WAP, nothing else. Set aside all your other issues you got going on that day and just really lock in for 1 good hour. And 1 good hour, 3 to 4 times a week, should really give you enough to cover some ground from the beginning of the year material. My second tip is to really focus on what you don't know. That's really where you all have to do some self-reflection to determine what you know and what you don't know. And this may seem like a given, but focus on what you don't know versus what you do know. Because in the end, the material that you feel confident in is going to sit there and reside in your brain and stay there for the exam. You're not going to lose that. Whereas the material that you're uncomfortable with, that's what you really have to then lock in on. And so focus on what you don't know. And the best way to identify what you don't know is in class, if we're reviewing topics or you're looking over the mock multiple choice during an office hours or workshop session with me. You know, and if you got dinged pretty hard on period one, then go back and look over some material on period one. Identify what you don't know. And the third, and I think this is the most vital tip that I can offer you, is to truly begin to learn to rely on each other. I know that there are gripes out there that I don't provide massive study guides. And I know that there are concerns about how to cover all that material dating back to sixth grade. But if you learn at this stage to find a partner or a group of partners to form a focused study group, I guarantee you that is going to be what you can do to rely on each other. We've talked about building teamwork and camaraderie up in the classroom all year long. And so I have no doubt that relying on each other in this pressurized environment this last month of the year is going to give you somebody to fall back on. I would recommend truly coming together as a team, whether it be big group, small group, and realize that all of you, the students taking the comprehensive exam, the students taking the AP exam, this has been 89 of you together in an awfully trying circumstance navigating your first AP course. come together, rally, you know, build each other up, don't bring each other down in this time, and help each other out as much as possible. So I'm going to now turn it over to my bassist Chandler students. They're the real veterans. They've done this many times, and they're going to give you some of their key insights into how to best navigate AP seasons. So bassist Chandler students, take it away.
Hi, everyone. So my quick advice to you for this AP exam is to just treat it as any other exam. Don't be too stressed out. I know it's easier said than done, but really, if you just lay back and think of it as just another regular exam, you've been through this, you're a bassist student, and in the long run, it's not really that stressful. And trust me, now that because you're a bassist student, you're gonna have plenty more to come. So realizing now that this is just another exam is a key factor in order to succeed. So make sure that you just be relaxed. Whatever you studied. And at this point, just try to go with your confidence. That's it. Be confident in your answers and just know that you have good teachers guiding you.
Hi, World History students. My name is Vanessa, and I was in your seats about 7 or 8 years ago, which is crazy to say. It makes me feel super old. When you're writing your essay, write as much as you can. Sometimes I think that when I look at a question, I'm like, great, I blank out and I think that I don't remember anything. But once I start writing things down and just like making a general outline, I realize that I start remembering a lot of the concepts that I didn't think I knew. So I know it sounds super cliche, but just remember that you know a lot more than you think you do, and you are your biggest critic and your biggest roadblock. So at the end, just relax and trust the process. Mr. Smith will not let you down. So good luck. Reach out to me if you need anything in the future. But yeah, have a great rest of the year.
Hey, 8th graders. My name is Abiram, and I'm a sophomore at NYU Stern. I've had the opportunity to know Mr. Smith not only as my AP US History teacher, but also as my basketball coach for 4 years. And so just know that even if you fail the exam, it can't be worse than when I lost to the playoffs during 8th grade. But on a more serious note, I hope you all are studying very hard for this exam. Though it is tough, I think it's very easy to overcome. So the first one is definitely answer all of the questions. The AP World History exam does not penalize you for guessing on questions. And so, especially on the multiple choice, you know, just take the guess. Otherwise, you're leaving money on the table. You would be shocked at how often people fail to guess. And finally, I know it sounds very repetitive and almost too easy, but please do eat well and sleep well before the exam. It is one of the most underrated things. I can promise you all that pulling an all-nighter before an AP exam is not the formula for success. So good luck to all of you 8th graders, and hopefully we all can crush the AP and get to summer.
So my tip is to not cram for the exam. I'm sure you heard this tip many times, or at least I hope you've been hearing this tip many times. But the reason why you should start studying for your exams, you know, 1 week or 2 weeks beforehand for 30 minutes to 1 hour every day is that our brain is better at recalling long-term memory. So by studying every day for 1 to 2 hours for a week or so, you're building on your knowledge and putting it into long-term memory. And our brain can recall that at a much quicker and a much better rate than we would short-term memory, which is just cramming for the exam 24 hours beforehand. So if you don't want to listen to Mr. Smith or any of your other teachers, at least listen to the science. At the very least, just eat something, because that exam takes like, 4 hours, and you do not want to go hungry during it.
I just wanted to hop on and wish you all the absolute best of luck for your upcoming AP exams. I know that APs are super, super stressful, but trust me when I say that it's going to be okay, you know.
Definitely when you have to memorize a lot of content, it's not enough to just read and reread or just to take notes from a book. You want to make sure that you're actively engaging with the information and making sure that you've memorized the topics. And the best way to test yourself, just continuously test yourself as you're learning information, I think, is flashcards. So I use electronic flashcards because writing them out is kind of a hassle. And you do them anywhere. You can get an app on your phone and things like that. So I started out using Quizlet because the UIs, the user interface, is a lot easier. But Anki, A-N-K-I, is another really great one that it has more of a learning curve just to getting to understand it. So maybe when you guys are in later high school or in college, you guys can start using that one. But I would definitely recommend using flashcards, because just in making them, you're kind of starting to interact with material, and then you can keep refreshing them, making sure you have all your content down. Don't make flashcards for things that you know, because that's just a waste of time. Use your time wisely, and make sure that you're, if there's things that are hard, do those first. Don't try to avoid the tough stuff, because you want to make sure that you're using your time wisely. Don't procrastinate, because that's something that I definitely still have a problem with. So slightly hypocritical advice on that one, but I hope that this helps you guys. Good luck, and make sure you guys don't stress again, and I know that you guys are going to do awesome, and this is getting really, really long, so I'm going to go, but good luck. If you think that I can help you personally in any way, Mr. Smith has my contact information. You guys can reach out to me. Yeah, all right, bye.
Good luck on taking your first AP exam. I remember I was in your place around 5 years ago, and taking your first AP can seem intimidating, but with the right strategies, you can ace the test. History is not a bunch of facts and rote memorization. When you're studying, ask yourself if you can create a story about the who, the what, the when, the where, the why, and the how. Taking the extra time to understand the context of a situation and why events occur will make studying much more productive and enjoyable. For the essays, I always found that brainstorming and outlining the points that I wanted to write before actually writing anything always kept me more organized so that I didn't run out of time. You can study 1,000 hours, but making sure you're healthy and energetic on the day of the actual test is a real deal breaker. So good luck. You got this. And as always, the past shapes the future. Bye.